Hey guys, welcome back to another multiplayer round. For those of you new to the channel, just joined in on after seeing and come from the Beat and Bam event, welcome aboard. This video is more typically what I'm doing on this channel, playing multiplayer rounds, commentating my way through them. You hear some of my thought processes and my plans as I'm figuring out each shot and what line to take. Occasionally we'll get some rounds as well where we have other people joining in and giving their commentary or event play when it comes up. Let's jump back into this one and keep this multiplayer round going. We have Scout and KP. Grizzly Gulch 5, that'll create some good separation right off the bat. Nokia, I don't have all those holes memorized, but that'll keep me some potential separation there at least on anything Nokia. And then Pioneer 7 is good separation, and Pioneer Bay 3 at the end creates a separation for that big water skip play. So starting out here on Grizzly Gulch 5, so light glide paradigm for me. Middle chevron on this hillside, and about half disco visor. See if it gets up here, I'm definitely missing the rock. Let's see if I can scoot up the backside. Yes! There we go, this gives me a lookout here. Way better than I did in Beat and Bam. 88 feet, so I got about 80 feet of power, just a little bit over. And drops me there in the basket. Everybody taking the eagle off the bat. Scout has definitely been one of the breakout players this last year, or this last couple seasons, so see if we can keep up with him there. KP always a strong player as well. It's going to go glide skip arrives to fight a little bit more into that wind. Let's see if I can get the angle just right. Still leaking a little bit left. This is going to be some work left for me for sure. 99 feet out. I'm going to aim a little bit right and go like 100 feet of power, I think, for that wind. Go, go! Oh, so close. Everybody taking the birdie. Nobody able to capitalize on that one there. Grizzly Gulch 4. I can run this with a little bit of a tailwind sapphire, but the musket works just fine. Aiming out to the right and slide it up here safe to the land. I think about the roll musket here, and it'll stop sooner, but it also has that chance of standing up and rolling straight into the water, which I want to avoid that. So I go with the windbreak musket. Leaves a little bit more of a throw-in, but less likely to go in the water. Alright, here we go. We made it out to Nokia. Let's go light glide paradigm. Aim down this building. Give it a straight pullback. Uh-oh, I didn't turn this enough. Uh-oh. Hit a tree. Hit a tree! Is it cement? No, nothing lucky for me. Of course, they both get their birdies. I'm 86 feet downhill, 70 feet of power. Ooh! Almost even missed that one. But we got the par, so now we're downstroke. Got some work to do to make it back up. Nokia bringing the separation. Here's a glide sapphire with about a half disc of Anheuser after aiming down at that bridge. A good little skip off the path there. Leaves us for a close tap-in. I've seen a lot of people taking that wide route, like Scout and KP. That's definitely something I should explore a bit more, getting wide and safe around those trees. Oh, Nokia 15, that's right. The forehand drive doesn't work. I'll go sapphire. It's a glide sapphire here. And the forehand drive won't make it in that wind. Sapphire, go! Yes! It's pushing too far towards the water. I don't want to mess that much Anheuser on it. This glide sapphire gets there perfectly because of that pushing wind. If it wasn't for that pushing wind, that glide sapphire would be landing in the water on that line, or I'd be looking to get lucky skipping over the top. Got a couple strokes on KP there, so we're right in the middle, not losing any elo. Pioneer Bay 7, this is some wind. I'll take glide skip arrive instead of paradigm. And let's see if I can scoot it up to the basket here. Get around the corner just right. Maybe a little bit right. Fade back, give me a big skip. Big skip! No, right into the tree. Might have a little bit of a look at it, but still a ways out here. Yeah, 161. I think I need to go like 170, 180 power. Here's 180. Let's see if we can drop this in, try to gauge the wind. What's online? Oh, I should have gone 170. Anyway, gonna be taking the birdie, hopefully. Oh, this isn't easy yet. It's fine. Yep, get the putt. Wouldn't normally putt 54 feet, but it's downhill, so it can carry there. We're right in the middle of the pack still. Pioneer Bay 8, too easy. Light glide paradigm, give it a straight pull down. If I hit trees or rocks or anything, no matter where I get here, it's another light glide to get over the top, as long as it's not a big headwind. This will be... I'll go glide water skip here. Try to get a little bit further to the right. See if I can be throwing backhand around the pyramid rather than another forehand, and it didn't quite get far enough. So it's another forehand. 448, so I gotta go glide skip to give it enough. Get up over this wall, and hopefully... Oh boy, skip back over. Skip back over. Hey! There's a lucky bounce for the day. It skips back over and gets me 55 feet, so 50 power. Getting it in, and we got the birdie. Still in the middle there. Pioneer Bay 3 is the last one. Anything can happen coming in here. Oh, this wind. This is... I can't get their backhand, I don't think. I'm gonna go forehand. This is a fun play you're about to see. I go forehand, water skip to the middle island. There we go, we got there. And Scout made it up their backhand. Impressed. But here's the power thing. Forehand again. I like this. Forehand again. And get the water skip. You don't want to end that dead skip area to the right where it's all shallow water. And this is a tough throw-in, but it's a makeable throw-in if you get here. I think a great way to deal with this wind. I'm going to aim it real high with the wind and the height. I think I have to throw this like 30 feet of power to barely toss that up there. And yes! Fun to get the eagle. Still taking the loss to Scout and stay in the middle against KP there. But absolutely a really fun round. I love being able to get creative there on Pioneer Bay at the end. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed, and as always, stay bogey free.